The other big story tonight, the tropics. I'm here in the First Alert Weather Center with severe weather expert Mike Lyons. And Mike, Hurricane Rina continues to pick up steam. We really got to keep our eye on her.
Yeah, we do. She's got stronger tonight. Winds are 80 miles per hour. And now the Florida Keys are in the cone of uncertainty for the first time. And I think the word uncertain certainly describes the track of the system. And by the way, before you show you the system, a little trivia for you. Tropical depression to a hurricane, Rina did it in 21 hours. That's the second fastest in history. The all-time record is Umberto back in 07. He went from depression to hurricane in 14 hours.
Wow.
So little trivia to put
Thank
away
you.
For you. Let's begin with a look at the latest satellite imagery of our hurricane. Cat 1 tonight could become a major hurricane. Folks in the Yucatan Peninsula, especially Cozumel and Cancun, very concerned about it. Tonight, it is just slamming that little dot. That's the Swan Islands. Three islands, about 3, 4, 5 miles wide. No one lives there, but it is owned by Honduras, and they usually have a Navy garrison there. If they do tonight, the boys and ladies are getting smacked. Look at the center of the storm right here. You can see the little island here, and according to the National Hurricane Center, hurricane winds right around 80 miles per hour. Still, those hurricane force winds are confined to a small area. This is a very tiny hurricane. The hurricane force winds only go out about 15 miles. The tropical storm force winds of 39 up to 73 miles per hour, they extend out over 100 miles. The storm continues to get better organized. Water temperature in this region running anywhere from 84 to 87 degrees, and it's very deep, warm water. And the upper level winds are helping ventilate the system. Hurricanes need to breathe, and we've got an excellent outflow channel on the northern side of the system. So it's very likely that Rina will continue to intensify, likely becoming a major hurricane down the road. Tonight, 80-mile-an-hour winds crawling across the central Caribbean, moving west-northwest at about 3 miles per hour. Forecast track from the Hurricane Center, really not that much of a change until we get to day 4 and 5. Here it is Wednesday, Category 3. As we head toward Thursday, right across Cozumel and Cancun, those resort communities, maybe as a major hurricane, and after that, taking a little turn back toward the south and maybe the southeast. But days 4 and 5 of this hurricane forecast, very much up in the air because the global models are just having a difficult time. Two models, the GFS and the WRF, want to take it across Florida. The primary consensus of the other models continue to keep it here in the Western Caribbean. Now, I'll tell you that most of the summer and fall, these two models have not performed very well, and the Hurricane Center at the moment is leaning more toward this consensus. But still, a lot of time to watch this system in the coming days. Back in August, we were talking about Irene. We talked about a hurricane tracker. For those of you who just came back, seasonal residents, now's the time to download our free hurricane tracker for your Apple iPad, for your iPhone, and for the Android. You get all the information on this storm instantaneously on your phone. We'll have more about the storm and your forecasts when I come back in a couple minutes.